There's a flood emergency unfolding in southwest Queensland. The Balon River has been rising for days and now it's due to peak higher than first expected.
Some residents in low-lying areas could be inundated, but most people are just glad to see the end of the drought that has crippled the region for years.
Floodwater spreads across the vast southwest, liquid gold from the heavens, filling dams and irrigation channels.
It's good for the down the water and the cotton farmers. And the old grazies down the bottom there, they'll be happy.
In Little Outback St George, the youngsters are seeing the Balon River in all its glory for the first time. What do you think, kids?
Yay!
For Casey Lockwood and her family, much has changed since their town last had water.
I only had two children in 2012 when we were evacuated for the last flood.
What do you reckon is the best thing about the water running?
It helps farmers and it's nice.
At Christmas, the Balon was just a trickle. Today, it's a raging torrent. The flood is predicted to reach 12.5 metres, spilling over the Jack Taylor Bridge and bringing water into low-lying homes.
It'll be an inconvenience from the point of view of those people who have to move out. They'll have a bit of a mess to clean up under their houses.
After the big floods of 2011 and 12, a lot of people in this low-lying part of town had retaining walls built around their homes. Others had their homes raised up on stilts with the help of government grants. Police are going door to door to ensure those most likely affected are prepared. No one is too concerned though. They're too busy celebrating the end of the drought.
Fantastic. Try and stop me smiling.
Well, slowly but surely, the Balon River continues to rise and it's expected that the bridge behind me here, which heads out further west towards Cunnamulla, will go underwater in the next 24 hours or so. But Melissa, with this emergency declaration in place, attention's very much turning to safety. We've just seen a few SES boats going up and down the river, and there's also quite a few police on the road, just making sure that motorists are heeding the warnings and not driving through floodwaters.